for the 161st time for more than 700,000 people. It's all about fair, fun, and tradition. This is the California State Fair, and this is the Car Czar Show. Welcome to the show. I'm Doug Brenna. That's a golden bear. And this is a caveman turkey leg. Oh, yeah. We must be at the California State Fair. And oh, boy, do we have a good one for you today. We'll start off by talking to Courtney Dempsey, who's telling us that if you think you're going to just go out and wash the family car this weekend, you'd better think again. You could be facing a monster fine. Plus, the number one mistake all of you, or at least 50% of you from my survey, are making when you buy a used car. It's a big problem. You need to know about it. We're going to clue you in on what not to do when getting that used ride before you fork over your hard-earned cash. But before we do anything, well, I better ditch the caveman turkey leg and replace it with one of these. Why? Because, yeah, I'm one of only four people left in the world who still use a BlackBerry. But it appears I'm not the only one who's interested in this dated technology. It looks like Volkswagen's also down with the berry.
There's no question that companies like Android, Microsoft, and Apple are all vying for an opportunity to interface you and your car. Well, now Volkswagen is zigging when everybody else is zagging. VW embracing, of all companies, BlackBerry to help them put more tech into your car. It's a risky bet given how much struggle BlackBerry has faced here in North America, but the company is saying that it might be a partnership that proves to be pretty powerful. Look for BlackBerry integration into Volkswagen products over the next few years. And speaking of applications, there's no shortage of them, especially when it comes to helping you and your family road trip. And among the more popular apps are ones that allow you to cruise through the countryside at around 70 miles an hour and allow you to, well, identify and possibly evaluate parks, historical sites, and other points of interest that you and your family might want to check out. Our favorite, though, has got to be, as parents, where do we let our kids go to the bathroom? These so-called potty apps are exploding in popularity, and why not? It helps our kids not to explode in the back seat. One of our current favorites is called Sitter Squat. It's sponsored by, of all companies, Charmin, the app allowing people to find a place and to record bathrooms anywhere in the world. So if you're in a new city and, well, nature calls, Sitter Squat helping to identify public restrooms, they even have photos. Hey, and if you find a hidden gem of a restroom that's not on the list, you can even add it to the database to help out future full-bladdered tourists.
Please don't squeeze the shine.
Okay, full disclosure, I like a clean rest stop. One that's got maybe a vending machine, good parking, and of course, is nice and clean. We're gonna give you a link to all of those apps right here, facebook.com/thecarsare. Speaking of a good break, these good folks have taken one from the State Fair talking about cars. How are you? Tell me your name.
Hey, Doug. My name's Bette.
Hi, Bette. How are you?
I'm Garrett.
Garrett, nice to see you.
I'm Mary.
Mary, good to see you. Fine-looking family. You guys got some car questions? Ask away. I'm all yours.
We have two questions.
Okay, let's hear them.
My question is, our brother has a 1965 Shelby.
Wow.
Pulled apart by a friend. Oh. And we want to know, is it worth putting back together, and how much would it be to get all the parts?
I wish I had a Shelby for every person who said my friend took apart my Shelby. Not uncommon, believe it or not, but very difficult to take probably what is a big pile of parts and now resurrect them. Here's the good news. The car that you speak of is worth money. You know that. Just the body panels and the frame itself have significant value. I would term stop the silly. You've had some guy who is wholly unqualified starting this project. Don't perpetuate that. Start making some phone calls. I'm gonna go ahead and email you a list of restorers here in the Sacramento Valley who would love to take this project on, but hold on to your fair-going caps. You're gonna have to invest a little. Here's the good news. That investment will pay off big time. Huge collector's market for a vehicle like the one that you described. Second question.
Okay. Oh, I used to have a 1973 canary yellow Karmann Ghia.
You owned this car.
I loaned it.
Did you and I go to college together? Because I'm pretty sure I knew a girl in college who had a canary yellow Karmann Ghia.
I want that car. Well, you want a 71.
So you want to know where to find it?
Where can I find either a 71 to 73 canary yellow?
Oh boy, boy, I remember these so air cooled. You lived in, I lived in New York. Are you sure we didn't go to college together? Okay, let me tell you this. There aren't a lot of guys who are as qualified, I think, in the area as I am when it comes to making good automotive decisions. But one guy, in addition to myself, is named Mike Hull. And he runs a store and owns it. It's called Bug Foreman's. And if there's anybody who knows about old Karmann Ghias and how to find them and how to get them running right, it's going to be Bug Foreman's. And I'm just going to say it. Hey, Mike, you owe me for that referral. Mike Hull at Bug Foreman's. And you promised to follow up with me.
Yes.
Okay. You guys, you're here on the Midway. You guys going to the bumper cars?
We're going everywhere. We'll
go. Are you, Garrett? You want a bumper car, don't you?
I think so.
I bet.
We'll go to the bumper cars first.
Possibly. He's tough. The reason I bring that up is that if you think you're just going to come to the fair, jump on the bumper cars, and have a great time, you probably will. But there's a lot more to it than that. Flavio Soria is over at the bumper cars, and Flav, you've stumbled in to sort of the back area, and they actually have to do maintenance on those things.
Look, I finally made it on my own. I'm taller than the sign. We do maintenance on our cars at home. It's fitting that we do maintenance on these cars here for the public to use. Yeah, they're bumper cars, but they still need maintenance. They're regulated by the state, so they're safe for everybody else. This technology, it hasn't changed, what, in the 80 years that it's been around? Basically, it's just turning on and off your light switch, and they work. But that's about all I can tell you about these things. Let's go talk to Ray. He'll let us know more about it. Hey, Ray, how are you?
Oh, really good.
This is the guy who maintains this ride. So tell me, what kind of things you got to do to keep this thing safe and maintenance?
Well, there's several things you got to do. You got to make sure that the contacts are clean all the time.
Underneath it, you mean?
Underneath, you got to make sure the floor stays clean.
Okay.
No debris, no metal. Contact makes it short.
Speaking of that, can we walk on the floor while
this
is on? We're not going to get shocked, are we?
It's all properly grounded. It's only a 12-volt system.
Okay. What's underneath the car itself?
You can see it's got brushes right here. These are the ones that make the contact on the floor. This is your drive motor, and here's your pedal contact, your on and off switch.
And these are the brushes that make contact with the floor in order to complete the circuit.
Complete one circuit, yes.
And then there's another brush back here, and these just are the trailing wheels.
Right. It's fairly simple.
Simple,
it's
straightforward.
The hardest thing on this ride to fix is the tires. It takes maybe about 5 or 6 crow bars and about 10 people.
Who makes them?
Goodyear.
Get out.
Goodyear, Firestone. Wherever we can get them from.
And there you have it, the underworkings of a bumper car.
All the secrets of the madness.
Well, can we go for a ride now?
Yeah.
Let's go, let's go. Oh no, I got hit by the hitch from the behind.
And as you can see, I'll get it out here in the middle. You can control it. You could actually stay in one spot, spin around all day long if you want to. All the control is in the front wheel, which is the drive motor. You have 2 steel wheels that are in the back.
Well, I think I'm good for here, but I want to challenge you to a race, Doug. Meet me here later. You and me, buddy, you're going down.
Flavio, we've seen it before. You're an amazing driver, incredible race car driver, and now you've peeled away at the soft underbelly of bumper cars. Hey, get over here. I want to have you help me look at a car we're going to be revealing in just a couple of minutes right here in the middle of the state fair. Come on over. I want to see you. Stick around. We got a lot more coming up. We, of course, are at the California State Fair. We're going to be talking with Courtney Dempsey, who's telling us that if you think you're just going to go out and wash the family car this weekend, you could be in for a big mistake. It has to do with new drought restrictions.
Get ready to wash this puppy.
Plus, the number one mistake my customers at my shops are making when it comes time to buy a used car. In fact, half of them have actually made this huge mistake. We'll tell you what it is. Plus, more live one-on-ones with people here at the California State Fair. Don't go anywhere. I gotta go get a turkey leg. More on the Car Czar Show next. Hey, if you've got a car problem, I'm ready to help you personally. Log on to facebook.com/thecarczar or stop into either of my shops in Sacramento or in Citrus Heights, and I'm happy to look at it myself and We'll diagnose it for free. All right, let's do it. Let's sync it up. Welcome back to the Car Czar Show. I'm Doug Brown. Yeah, it's the California State Fair. And you knew that if I was going to be here, sure, I like the arts and the crafts and the farm exhibit, but it's really the food that gets me going because, heck, if you can deep fry a Twinkie, you can pretty much deep fry anything. You know, though, a lot of the folks here coming to the fair often buy used cars, as do a lot of you at home. But recently, after talking to a whole lot of my customers, I realized that fully one half of everybody who buys a used car in California makes this mistake.
It's something almost all of us have done, selling our used car to a private party. Simple enough, especially when you get cash on the spot for it. But are you also breaking the law? Well, recently I talked to a whole lot of my customers, and almost one half of them actually did in fact break the law when selling their used car. The California Vehicle Code is very clear about one thing. If you sell a car, you must provide the buyer with a valid smog inspection. Failure to do so literally invalidates the sale. So if you're buying a car, it becomes even more important. And here's why. If you do not get a smog certificate when you get the car, you could be in for big trouble. Because in some cases, the cost of getting the car into smog compliance could cost more than the car itself. Remember, if you're thinking about buying a car and the seller does not hand you a valid copy of a current smog inspection, run away. This is not a car that you want to buy.
And it really is important because remember, if you forget that part, meaning the smog check, you're just inviting a whole lot of trouble, and I would never, ever buy a car that I didn't get a smog inspection before the purchase, along with the title to the car. Well, it is, of course, the State Fair, which means there's a lot of people like the Madsons who have a lot of automotive questions. Wow, Mrs. Madsen, good to see you. Mr. Madsen, how are you?
Fine.
Welcome to the fair. You have a car question. What is it?
What would be the best long-term strategy for buying a car model, whether it be gas, hybrid, or all electric?
Yeah, that's a great question, and we've talked a lot about it on the show, but I don't think I've ever even made that totally clear. I think we continue to evolve what is the new normal. And certainly hybrids, now that they've been on the road for about 10 years, have really proven themselves. But one of the mistakes that people make with hybrids is that they're using them wrong. For example, if I live, say, 30 miles from where I work and I'm on the freeway every day, it's not typically a good usage of the hybrid technology because I'm doing 55 miles an hour. But if I live, say, in the downtown area of Sacramento and I commute a mile or two, that's a great use. I will tell you this, sooner rather than later, we're gonna see an entirely new choice emerge, and that's gonna be hydrogen fuel cell technology. It's here, it's coming, and we better be ready for it. So I think what'll happen in the very near future is you'll go to the dealership with your boys and dad and mom, and you won't just have to pick the color or two or four door, you're gonna have to pick what's under the hood. You'll have your choices: gas, diesel, electric, hybrid, or fuel cell. That's five different choices, and that's where the decision's gonna be made. It's a good case for a little bit of research up front before you go look at that new car. It's gonna pay off big time. And the other thing I'll tell you is this: all of those choices are gonna be available in most cars sooner rather than later, as I said. And wait for it, diesels too. We're gonna start seeing more and more diesels showing up in things like SUVs, sedans, and even small cars, much like you see in Europe. I hope that answers your question. A long-winded answer to a very good, short question. All right, good to see you. Oh, wait, we have something for you. Throw that in here. It's the official Madsen cotton candy. That we have mad budget here on the Car Czar Show. It's good to see you guys. Enjoy the rest of the fair. I know that I enjoy the fair as well. And if you thought that I was gonna come all the way out here and not review a brand new car, well, think again. It's the all new Hyundai Elantra. And oh, lo and behold, look who's driving it. None other than major fair going guy himself, Flavio Soria. Only you would pull a new Hyundai onto Midway here at the State Fair. I like this car. I'm gonna tell you right now, we've talked about it a lot on the show. I'm getting out of the way because it's far better looking than I am. What do you think?
I think it's a fantastic car, I gotta tell you. Stickers for under $20,000.
Awesome.
Unbelievable. Fully loaded as it is, 24.6. It's a lot of car for the money.
Now, I know it's got just a 2-liter four banger underneath the hood, So my question is always going to be this. Does it have enough power?
You know what? I think it has sufficient power for what it is and for who's going to have it.
And gas mileage is pretty darn good. You're talking about something that is going to get around 30 miles to the gallon.
Even more on the highway. I mean, combined, it's high 20s, early 30s. Come on now.
Comfortable inside? Ride quality?
Extremely.
Yeah. A lot of people still are concerned about Hyundais and their ability to hold on to resale value. I think that's changing, but it's not as good as Honda, Toyota is ever going to be. I mean, that's the reality.
That is the reality of it. Build quality has gotten a lot better, but you get a 10-year, 100,000 mile powertrain warranty on it. Come on now.
Yeah, it's hard to go wrong with that. And I will tell you this, the design of these cars is exceptional. You may not get the resale that you get from a Toyota or a Honda, but gosh darn, you're going to get more styling.
I agree. The styling is top notch on this. It looks very sporty, very modern. That's what I like about it.
And you don't look at this car and say, oh my gosh, that's a Hyundai.
No, exactly. No. Exactly. Right. That's a beautiful car.
It's in showrooms right now. If you want more information, it's facebook.com/thecarczar. Hey, look, I know that you're out here with me.
Yes.
Which begs the question, where the heck is Courtney Dempsey?
That's what I want to know.
Yeah, I know. I actually do know. She's back in East Sacramento. Courtney, talking about a couple of things. Obviously, when we talk about the State Fair, we're talking about a whole lot of heat and everybody's looking for water. But when it comes to washing your car, you better be careful given how severe the drought is that we have right now.
Absolutely. And I'm telling you, and starting off with this big old bucket of water, you know what I'm going to do with this first? Go ahead and douse the car because I'm getting ready to wash this puppy. But we've got some rules, people. You know, if your address is an odd number, you water on what day, Jessica?
You water on Tuesdays or Saturdays.
Mm-hmm. And so Sundays and Wednesdays are reserved for those even number addresses, right?
That's
okay,
correct.
So we got that rule. But did you also know that applies to washing your car, too? So, Jessica, you say first things first, get the bucket full of water first.
Get the bucket full of water first. Okay. Actually, Courtney, the first thing you should really do is make sure that you have an auto shut-off hose nozzle. Use that to fill up your bucket.
And then we actually use this to rinse the car first,
get the
right?
car wet.
Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and do that, get the car wet. And then you're saying because you want to make sure that you're kind of keeping track of how much water that you're actually using on the car.
That's correct.
Which is another reason why people are shocked to find out that car washes are actually better than washing your car yourself at home.
That's true.
Yeah.
We estimate that at home you use about 100 gallons of water when you wash your car for 10 minutes. And at a car wash, they use significantly less than that because they actually recycle the water in between the car washes. So the wash that you're using at the car wash might be used on four or five other cars, but it's still clean enough to wash your car.
Good to know. Kind of cool that we're washing the car on the grass, yeah?
That is cool because guess what? The soap that gets onto the lawn here is actually filtered before it hits the storm drains and flows straight to our local creeks and rivers.
Oh, that is good to know. Good to know. Okay, so here we go. We're washing the car. Let's say we've gotten to the end of the wash.
Mm-hmm.
So you say go ahead and finish up whatever soap is in the bucket.
Yep,
and then
up.
Reuse that bucket again to rinse that car.
Yep. Go ahead, dump that whatever's left in that bucket, fill it back up with clean water, and then throw that clean water right back up on the car.
I dig it. Okay, so let's say, boop, this is our last little rinse here. With the soapy water, we fill this back up with the nice clean water. And again, we're trying to cut down because this drought is serious.
It is a serious deal.
All right. Well, listen here, Doug. We got a little bit more washing to do. What I'm going to do is offer her a lemonade from your fridge since you're hanging out at the fair with the fried food.
Courtney, I appreciate it. And it looks a lot shadier and I'll admit a little bit cooler over where you are in East Sac than where we are here on the Midway. Okay, Flavio, I'm gonna admit it. You're back inside the car. I love bumper cars, don't you?
Love the bumper cars,
get
man.
Get this car out of here because when we come back, we're talking bumper cars, how to come to the State Fair and just beat the heck out of anybody you're going up against. Don't go anywhere. The Car Czar Show continues from the California State Fair.
It seems to be a question that everybody asks. How do I find a good mechanic? An honest mechanic, a mechanic who will do a great job at a very reasonable price. At the Car Czar, we are your answer for all of those questions. You see, I started our first garage with my dad back in the 80s, and the things that he taught me then, I still adhere to today. Great parts, great mechanics, and great prices. So it's really not that hard to find a great mechanic. Just let me help. The Car Czar Auto Repair in Sacramento and in Citrus Heights.
No matter if you're a teen, a senior, or just in need of a quick refresher, nobody should ever be uncomfortable taking driving lessons. At Bond Driving School, every student receives a customized experience from the industry's most highly trained and expert professionals. For 50 years, Bond Driving School has been doing it better than anyone else, creating safe and confident drivers, no matter how old you are. So remember, when it comes to the best driving instruction anywhere, all roads lead to Bond.
The Car Czar Show supports Wellness Within. It's a nonprofit mind-body wellness center for patients, survivors, and families coping with the stress of cancer. The Wellness Center, 609 Oak Street in Roseville. Log on for more information at wellnesswithin.org.
This portion of the Car Czar is brought to you by Ion Camera. Shoot in high def and share in real time. Ion Camera, the official camera of the Car Czar Show.
Hey, welcome back to the show. Yeah, it's the bumper cars, and this might be the weirdest thing I've ever done with another grown man.
You think?
Who's steering?
You're steering.
I'm steering.
I got the gas.
You know, when you said we were going to do the bumper cars together, I thought it was me against you. All right, until next week, when we're in any car, we don't talk on the phone.
And we don't text either.
We don't text. Until next week, from the bumper cars, the California State Fair. Let's go.
Come
Have
on.
A great week. This might be the slowest bumper car. Oh, here we go. All right.
Go faster. Go faster.
Woo. I'm going around the 24 car. Expect it.
No, it's a good thing we're not at the marine race. Oh, there he is again. Turn the camera. Ah!
Oh. Welcome to the State Fair.
Give me your best Michael Jackson.
Come on!
Hit the ground.
10-minute rule.
Whoa.
I don't want to waste all your pixels.
The Car Czar Show relies on a leap ahead IT for all of its technical and computer services. IT management that's affordable, that's expert, that's just plain easy to use. A leap ahead IT. Construction and building services provided by Sacramento Oak Crest Company. Sacramento Oak Crest, an A-plus rating from the Better Business Bureau. If it can be built, if it can be remodeled, Oak Crest can do it perfectly. Sacramento Oak Crest Company.
Doug Browner is the owner of the Car Czar Auto Repair in Sacramento and Citrus Heights.